Joplin continues. Now Fox 4's Abby Eden and I spent days and nights working together in Joplin in the immediate aftermath of that tornado, an event that will always stay with us. Certainly Abby here now with a look at the stories of survival and sadness that I know you think about, I think about. It really was a game changer for us.
It really was, and it's hard to believe it's been 6 months, but sure through is. That 6 months of covering all the destruction and the rebuilding in Joplin, the Fox 4 team really had the privilege of meeting some people with incredible spirits. While material possessions are few in the city right now, eager and thankful people are many. Among the scenes of destruction,
it's a miracle we're alive, and thank God we are.
Were broken homes, broken bones, and broken hearts.
We never thought it would happen to us, and it does happen to you.
Stephen Wiersing is one whose body was broken. He had a head wound, broken bones, a chest wound so big his heart could be seen beating, and his lungs were infected with zygomycosis. His father was only able to identify Stephen because of a tattoo.
But I'm glad he got it.
After more than 3 months in a Kansas City hospital, the teen who had less than a 10% chance of surviving was wheeled out with a smile and newfound love for his family.
I didn't think they were that important, but now I realize that's my life.
Amy, another survivor, made it through with just a broken arm, cracked hip, and pelvic bone. But her emotional scars run deep. After the tornado passed, what she saw terrified her.
A tree laying across the top of us. People's bodies, dogs. Even though I can picture it all in my head, second by second, that was going on, I can't explain it to you.
Amy was released from the hospital. Others didn't even make it there, like Will Norton.
I actually went out there to tour college.
Will graduated high school the day the tornado ravaged Joplin. He was on his way home with his dad when he was reportedly sucked out the sunroof of the SUV he was riding in by the wind and thrown. His body was later found in a pond. Will's legacy lives on in Joplin with wildebeest signs and bracelets, something Will was known for, and his legacy continues through his YouTube videos that made him a fan favorite. Lage Grigsby is blessed to survive. Shortly after the storm, his family tries to take their minds off their suffering by going to an airport filled with local and state leaders. And that's where we met them.
I miss him, and I hope he comes back okay.
Grigsby was in the Home Depot parking lot with his grandmother. He was sucked out of the truck he was sitting in and found with a gaping head wound. The teen miraculously survived, his family believes, because of prayer.
Please pray.
Harry Carmona lost her husband and a daughter in the storm while they were at church. She used $2,000 her husband saved to remodel their home to give to a charity called the Hope Station. She says hope is the only thing that gets her through.
Kind of amazing knowing that I made it out.
And teenager Quentin Anderson, ready to start his senior year. This teen came home from a fishing trip to be with his parents. The storm made a direct hit on his house.
Our whole house got picked off the foundation and torn apart.
He says he remembers being hit by something and waking up with a shattered back, broken eye socket, and skin stripped from his legs. The worst part, both of Quentin's parents were dead. Amazingly, Quentin takes the news in stride.
I knew I lost them and everything, but I think of it as they didn't lose me. Everyone has to bury their parents, but no one should have to bury their child. What I'm going to do in my life is what they wanted me to do.
While 161 people died, those people aren't forgotten by the thousands who survive and promise to live for their honor. According to Lage Grigsby's Facebook page, he was able to start his school year on time. And we spoke with Quentin Anderson on his first day of school when he was planning to move into a house closer to Joplin to live with a friend's family. He's now deciding on colleges. And, you know, it is really neat to look back and see all of the hardship these people have gone through. And they were still able to get back to their normal lives in a remarkable amount of time.
6 months. Unbelievable.
Yes, yeah. Absolutely. All and right. It's neat to see and really cool to see how the spirit really has not changed for those people down there.
Abby, thank you.
Thank you.
There is one.